presentasi yang materi 1 sampai 5 itu menggunakan apa PowerPoint.
Ya.
Kalau untuk nomor TTM yang kedua presentasi di sini.
Yes.
Tapi menggunakan PowerPoint.
Oke, bisa menggunakan PowerPoint, nanti saya Miss mengusulkan kita punya proyektor. Itu tergantung.
Ada.
Oh iya.
Tadi juga salah kok.
Oh, I see. Ya.
Kan itu saya absen sakit, tulisnya apa ya?
Absen. Just sign. Tanda tangan ini aja. Oke, ada lagi, guys? Do you have questions so far before we start our lesson? No? Berarti udah jelas ya? Nanti kalau misalnya temannya mau nanya, dijelasin juga dengan apa yang udah Miss jelasin. Oke? Okay, jadi sekarang kita belajar tentang predicate. Come on. Open your... Coba dibuka modulnya, modul 6 tentang
nggak bisa Miss.
Kayaknya tadi Miss buat gini ya. Nggak bisa lagi ya. Oh ya guys, jadi kita sekarang belajar tentang predicate. What do you know about predicate? Are you sure kata keterangan?
Kerja.
Oke, okay. Kata kerja, kata keterangan, apalagi? Ayo, what do you know about predicate? Kata keterangan. Mbak Hana? Kata keterangan.
Kata kerja.
Mbak Widya, kata kerja yang mana? Yang kata kerja satu pilih ya. Kan suka dua, satu aja.
Kata keterangan.
Kata keterangan. Widiawati.
Kata keterangan.
Kata keterangan. Hani.
Keterangan.
Keterangan. Anjas.
Kata kerja.
Kata kerja. Halo Pak.
Kata kerja.
Chandra.
Kata keterangan.
Oke. Okay. Sebelum kita bilang, so we already study about noun, adjective, apalagi adverb. So here noun as a apa itu noun?
Kata
benda.
Adjective
kata sifat.
Kata
sifat.
Adverb
kata dari jawaban.
Kata terjemahan itu
keterangan dari kata benda atau kata
verb
kata kerja.
So verb is a predicate. So kenapa kita pertama sekali belajar noun phrase, adjective phrase, adverb phrase? This is the small one. So you need to know what is noun, what is adjective, what is adverb, what is verb. Sebenarnya bahasa Inggris itu gampang kalau kamu tahu apa itu noun, apa adjective, apa adverb, apa verb. Jadi kalau misalnya I am teaching what semester are you now? The first semester. I am teaching the first semester. I here as a subject. I'm teaching here as a verb. The first semester as an object. Udah? Ini dia structure umumnya. I as a subject. Kalau kita udah pelajari subject itu masuk di kategori mana? Noun kah? Adjective kah? Adverb kah? Verb kah? apply as a subject di kategori mana?
Noun.
Noun.
Bukannya
noun.
Noun.
Oh, noun.
Yes. Noun, right?
Right.
I'm teaching as a verb.
Okay.
Here, the first semester as a object. Yang mana dia di sini?
Adverb.
First semester. First semester, kalian first semester, kalian benda apa gimana nih?
Yes.
Kalian orang kan?
Yes.
Berarti mana dong?
Verb?
No. So when you can analyze the kinds of sentence, udah bisa dong, apalagi udah tahu mana subject, mana verb, mana object. Ini dia hal umumnya. Tahu di mana yang mana subject, mana verb, mana object. Nah, di sini baru kita pelajari lagi ke hal yang lebih kecil. Ada am, ada teaching, ada I, ada they, ada first, ada semester. I, it comes from pronoun. I, you, she, he, it, we, you, they. Come on guys, I want to ask you, what is the difference between you here and here? There are two you, right?
Yes.
What is the differences between the first one and the second one? Come on. I'm trying to make the example. For example, hi Hannah, how are you?
I'm fine.
This is the first example. When I'm coming from the door, I'm said, hello guys, how are you? It means I'm asking all of you, right?
Yeah.
So here, you as Mbak Hana, it means
singular.
Yeah, singular. Remember, singular is just one. And here, all of you.
Plural.
It means more than
one.
So remember, this is personal
pronoun.
Bahasa Indonesianya kata ganti
pertama.
Dewi. Kata ganti dewi. Kata ganti dewi bahasa Inggrisnya personal
pronoun.
Jadi di dalam bahasa Inggris itu personal pronoun itu enggak lebih enggak kurang dari sini. Just remember, I, you, she, he, it, we, you, they. So remember, there are two you here. You here as a singular, remember, you just one. You here as a plural, more than one. Dua orang, tiga orang, atau terserah. Yang penting hanya lebih dari dua orang. Do you get it? Do you get it?
Yeah.
Do you have question?
Yeah.
Come on.
Kalau pertanyaannya how many dengan how much itu pengaruh nggak sih sama
itu belum di sini nanti be patient sabar ya. Oke, ini dulu ya yang mana. Do you have question? Nah, jadi kita tadi udah belajar, kita kan mau belajar predikat nih, kita harus dari small dari sini dulu, kita buat sample. I am teaching the first semester. I as a subject, it comes from personal pronoun. I'm teaching as a verb, that kinds of verb, action. You know verb, when you are doing the action, it means verb. Just, that's verb. Talking, when, that's laughing, that's verb. When you're writing, that's verb. What kinds of action are you doing, that's verb. Hanya tindakan yang beraksi ya, melakukan itu kerja, namanya kerja, tau gak? Kerja. So remember, jadi kalau saya itu belajar bahasa Inggris itu kaitkan, oh iya ya, kerja berarti ada action, oh that's verb gitu, noun, kata benda. Aku benda apa? Aku benda hidup kah? Benda mati kah? Atau gak benda kah? Gak sama sekali. You can think it, buat logically. Aku benda apa? Ask yourself, aku benda apa? Benda hidup, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, when you are asking yourself, aku benda apa ya? benda mati kah? Di situ kau bisa tahu, oh noun. Noun itu berarti benda, ada benda hidup, ada benda mati. Aku dong contohnya, oh meja. Oh ini meja, nggak hidup, nggak ada nafasnya. Lalu, oh benda mati, berarti noun. Berarti kamu tahu contoh noun itu apa. Right? Right? Okay, so now, the most important things is you need to know what's noun, what is adjective, what is adverb, what is verb. So here, in this sentence, when you know I as a subject, it comes from personal pronoun. I am teaching as a verb, that's action. I'm teaching, action, work, 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 kerja. You need to do action, okay? The first semester, here also, Miss jelaskan secara sekilas, tapi jangan masuk ke dalam kalian, nanti kamu membingungkan. They here, there is article, it comes from a, and, the. Nanti kita ada waktunya belajar ini. Jadi semua dalam bahasa Inggris itu ada unit-unit ke dalamnya. Tapi yang perlu kamu ketahui yang besar dulu. Hal-hal umum dulu yang harus kamu mengerti, baru masuk ke hal yang lebih dalam. Nah di sini lagi, ini kan ada am, miss. Ada to be, ini datang dari to be. Is, am, are. Oh ini miss, kenapa ini teaching? It comes from teach. Kenapa ada ing miss? Itu dari jiran. Kalau kita belajar lebih dalam ke dalam lagi. But now, you need to know is the just the general one. Which one is subject, with what, which one is verb, and the object. So remember, kata ganti diri yang ada di dalam bahasa Inggris hanya I, you, she, he, it, we, you, they. Gak lebih, gak kurang dari situ. Just remember, I is means I. You, it means one people or singular. Okay? She, it calls for the woman, for the girl, and he for the boys or the for the man. It, it personal pronoun from to say the thing, or the animal, and that kinds of thing lah, something like that. We, kita. Pengertian dari we ini ada dua, miss. Ada kita, ada kami. Mana perbedaannya? Apa beda kita dengan kami? Kita, kami, kita.
Kita itu untuk
kita. Kita untuk dua orang,
oh,
kami
untuk lebih banyak, lebih dari dua orang.
Lebih dari dua orang. It means you are trying to answer is singular or plural?
Plural.
Kita plural, ya. Yeah. Apa bedanya kita dengan kami? Miss buat contohnya. Kita nanti belajar bahasa Inggris ya. Kita. It means you include in me. Kamu masuk dengan saya. But kami nanti mau belajar bahasa Inggris. You are not. That's the differences. Remember, kita, it means you are including in me, but kami, you are not. Tapi kalau dalam bahasa Indonesia, that's same, right? But in English, when you know this kind of kita and kami. So kita, you are including in, but kami, you are not including. Do you have question? Atau kalau saya bahasa Inggris ngerti nggak? Gimana? Do you get it?
Yeah.
So remember, before we study about predicate, we need to know the sentence subject. So in the sentence, in a sentence, di dalam sebuah kalimat, dikatakan sebuah kalimat itu apabila terdiri dari subject dan predicate, verb. Object, that's like additional information. If you just say I work, it's a sentence. I as a subject, work as a verb. Okay? So predicate, it means verb. Verb. So now, let's study about kinds of predicate. Verb. There are verb 1, verb 2, verb 3. Come on guys, what is the example of verb 1?
Take.
Taken. Yes. And then that's a new example. What is your example? Things, what's your example?
Doing?
No. Doing? No. What is your example, honey? I'm waiting for your answer still. Wait, honey.
Eating?
No. Come on, try to remember. What's up?
Eaten.
Got you. What's up? I'm still waiting for your answer. And Jess, what is your answer?
Calm.
Calm is adjective. Calm. Banyak kata kerja. Jalan. Ha. Aku aja ngomong ini. Ha. Speak. And then speaking, are you sure? Spoken. Sandra, what is your example? What's up? No, come on, thinking. Papa. Eight? Oh, this guy.
Eaten.
Yes. Eaten. Bapak melengkapi punya Hanik, Pak. Cancur punya orang.
Sudah.
Make yours. Das? No. Nanti Miss jelaskan apa itu das. Sandra, what is your example? Come on, think. What is your example? Example of verb 1, verb 2, verb 3.
Big.
Big is S and Z. Big.
Sit.
Look. Looking.
Sound.
It comes from
sin.
Look. The same, yeah? Papa.
Go.
Jadi data kan? Verb 1, that's the first verb. Verb 2, that's the second verb. Verb 3, that's the third verb. Jadi di dalam kata kerja itu ada dia kata kerja pertama, kata kerja kedua, kata kerja yang ketiga. Dan ada juga jenisnya, ada irregular verb, ada regular verb. Ada kerja beraturan, kata kerja yang tidak beraturan. Nanti lebih lanjut lagi kita pelajari, kalau sekarang nanti kalian muntah.
Itu SMP ya, Miss?
SMP?
Waktu SMP itu bukan ya?
Hah? Was were? It's not. So, kata kerja ada juga linking verb. Linking verb, that's to be. Nah, here, that is a verb. Predicate as a verb. And also, there is linking verb. That's the example, linking verb is am, are. And also, there is auxiliary modal, auxiliary verb. It's like may, could, can, will. Modal itu kata kerja. Apa modal auxiliary? apa mau datang juga ya, come on. Ayo, nanti chattingnya. Apa mau dalam jewelry, guys? Itu loh, Miss May, ya mana? Untuk mengetahui predikat. Model auxiliary. Look at the I have here. You didn't read your book. Come on, look at your book. Di mana ada dibuat modal auxiliary? Do you get it?
6 and 47 there is model predicate.
Yeah, so look at 623, exercise 3, 623. Mati ya tulisan dokter. Coba dilihat, exercise 3. Identify the modal predicates of the following paragraphs that modifies the subject. Modal predicate, kata kerja ban. Kata kerja bantu. Kata kerja bantu. Okay, let's go on. So here, there's a linking verb. Maksudnya di sini linking verb itu apa hubungannya dengan predicate, Miss? Is MR juga bisa sebagai verb. For example, I am teacher. Here, I as a subject, am as a verb, teacher as a object. So, linking verb, it kinds of predicate. Okay? Do you get it? Yeah, so remember, linking verb is a to be, is MR. Now, let's see modal auxiliary verb. May, could, can, will, shall. Banyak lagi, might, couldn't, something like that. The example, for example, I can find you. I as a subject, can find as a modal auxiliary, as a verb, you as object. It kinds of predicate. Are you get it? Do you have question? Artinya can itu dapat. May artinya boleh. What is the differences between dapat dan boleh? Can and may. What is the differences between both words? Come on. can and may.
Can itu udah pasti, may itu belum pasti.
Can udah pasti, may
ya,
belum pasti.
Sering digunakan hampir
maybe.
So, what do you know about these kinds of example? For example, can I borrow your pen or may I borrow your pen?
So it kinds of polite, more polite than can. Do you know polite?
Yeah. So, when you are trying to borrow some money or like something from your friends, just when you're in the same age, you just say, can I borrow something? But when you're talking to your teacher, to your professor, to your mother, to your something other than you, may I?
Oh yeah, I see, miss. Like, may Allah show rahmah and blessing for us, not can Allah. I see.
Yeah. So in, yeah, in me also, like, may God.
My God.
Not can God. Yeah. So that's kind of.
Jadi kalau kamu tahu perbedaan can dengan may,
ya kamu tahu mengaplikasikan dalam kalimat, dalam conversation, it's very good. So like I'm an English teacher, when you are trying to speak in English, just say Miss Petroy, can I say while here I'm your teacher. So I see. But when you can apply this kind of words, not just to me, maybe for the other teacher, for your boss also, like Miss Lalu, gak cuma bos ya, sama teman-teman juga bagus sih. Seperti contohnya, aku mau gini, boleh nggak? I want this, may I? Something like that. Okay? Okay. You can write it now. I give you time. Come on, if you want to write, just write. Finish. So, jadi pas Miss menjelaskan kamu menulis.
Saya nggak bisa nih kalau misalnya kita Miss menjelaskan terus saya hanya mendengarkan. Jadi saya sambil mendengarkan, saya sambil menulis.
I see. Okay. Come on. Question, honey.
I want to ask you.
Kalau biggest itu maksudnya short apa?
Biggest. Okay. So here, okay. I'm trying to answer your question, Tandra. Where should I write? Here. The first one, many and much. Ini bukan kata kerja. Ini penggolongan untuk mendescribe benda sebanyak. Artinya sama-sama banyak. Banyak
tapi bisa.
Ya, jadi many itu for countable noun. Countable noun, remember. Noun, again noun. Kata untuk menghitung, kata benda yang bisa dihitung. For example, can I count this one, board maker?
Yes.
It means if you want to say banyak, many board makers. Okay? But like if you want, so remember here, countable noun. It means you can count that things, that noun, bisa dihitung. Okay? While much here, you cannot count. It means uncountable noun.
Sugar.
Yeah, for example, sugar. Kamu kan ngambil satu-satu gulanya. Ini satu miss, dua miss. No, sugar itu satu cangkir, satu sendok, satu karung, something like that. Rice also, milk, hair, something like that. Do you get it, Sandra? So remember, many is for the, if you want to count a noun, and you can count, you can say many. But if you cannot count the things that noun, you cannot say many, but much. Itu kan yang tugasnya.